In this video, is the Cardano price forming a potential bullish trend reversal? Stay tuned to know more. So hi guys, and welcome back to another Gab's cryptocurrency video where we trade by data and not by hype. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, click the subscribe button down below and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out daily technical analysis like this. So let's dive into this video. So today we're going to have a Cardano analysis because I want to show you something na nakita ko dito sa ating Cardano chart. And there are two things na gusto ko ipakita sa inyo. First things first is actually in the weekly time frame, and then the other one is actually in the daily time frame. So ito yung gusto ko muna ipakita sa inyo in the weekly, kasi if you're going to look at the weekly, Cardano has not actually been on a significant downtrend. Rather, I think if you're going to look at this, if you're going to plot this support, and then if you're going to plot another resistance area dito sa taas, you would actually notice na instead of being on a downtrend, it was actually still more of a consolidation siya if you're going to look at this in the bigger time frame. And then considering na if you're going to look at where was Cardano when it was around January 2021, you would actually notice during January 21, Cardano was actually around the 0.19 cents. And then ever since today, we actually went up, and kahit na we are on a decline with the Cardano price action, you can actually see na we are still up 436% pa din. So in this case, that could indicate na I don't think na Cardano is on a bear trend. Rather, Cardano is actually more on a consolidation area pa din, similar to what we have been seeing the whole year. So if you're going to look at the whole year, you could actually see na this was a bullish price action. But yun nga, if you're going to look at that, we did not go any higher dito sa ating previous all-time high. So this is actually giving me a thoughts na this could be possibly a very long consolidation area kay Cardano. Kasi in fact, this long consolidation can be somewhat similar to a reaccumulation area. Kasi look at this, it's pretty much still within the similar price range pa din, within the $1 up until the $2 area. So there's still no change kay Cardano within the whole year. But if you have been trading this for the very short term, of course, you are able to maximize those pump and dump movement na nakita natin with Cardano within the year 2021. But in general, in the bigger picture, if you're going to look at this, you would notice now we have been still moving sideways with the Cardano price action. But on top of that, ito din yung maganda ipakita dyan, which is actually this 50-week moving averages. Kasi previously, the 20-week moving average was actually the previous support for the Cardano price action. Unfortunately, when we started breaking down from the 20-week EMA or 20-week MA, we started going down to the 50-week, and then now we are now going down to the 100-week. And look at this, upon reaching around the 100-week, I think we are starting to get some bounces off dito kay Cardano, and that is somewhat a good thing na magkaroon tayo ng bounces dyan. But ang bad thing na ngayon dito is the 50-week MA is now going to act as a resistance, similar with the 20-week moving average. So even though now we are going to see a bullish retracement dyan kay Cardano price action, what we now have to watch out is this previous support is now going to act as a resistance for Cardano. So even if we are going to see a bullish retracement, we have to watch out for this 20-day moving average, 20-week moving average pala. Kasi this could be a crucial resistance. Let's say we are seeing a bullish retracement dito kay Cardano. Then yeah, we have to break the 20-week MA in order for us to continue to the upside. But ito yung mas maganda ipakita sa inyo guys, kasi right now in the daily time frame, the Cardano is actually forming this declining price action. Ayun na, the price is declining while the oscillators are increasing. Look at the RSI has been increasing, and then look at this, the MACD has also been increasing, showing us two indicators na possibly na Cardano might be forming a bullish divergence. And a bullish divergence is wherein the price is declining but the oscillators are increasing, indicating na nagkakaroon ng strength yung coin. That is somehow an indication of a possible bullish trend reversal. So right now, this is what I'm actually monitoring with the Cardano price action. And then if you're going to look at certain resistance on what we can monitor with the Cardano price action, if let's say we are going to see a bullish retracement, then I think a best resistance to watch out for this one is actually around the $1.52 area. Kasi look at that, doon tayo nakuha ng previous resistance. And then similarly, that same area was actually our previous support. So right now, if we are going to follow a bullish divergence, our first target na pwede natin tingnan would be the $1.51 area. And then let's say you want to plot a Fibonacci retracement indicating kung ano ba yung magiging next resistance areas natin. We could actually plot from the previous high to the lowest low. Let's try to plot to the lowest low. And then you can actually see na right now we are at a strong resistance around the $1.09. So $1.09 is now a pretty strong resistance to watch out dito in order for us to break this. Pero if na-break natin si 1.09, then I think ang magiging next movement natin would be around the 1.19 and then 1.26 and so on. But as you can see, we have to break 1.09 first before saying that we are now going to flip to the upside. And yeah, this is actually in the daily time frame. So this is actually a very big time frame. So this is not a time frame na inaabangan mo within the day. This is a time frame na you have to wait within 2 or 3 more days. Kasi of course, daily time frame does not happen immediately within the very short term. Daily time frames are of course something na you have to be very patient if you want to trade the daily time frame movement. So in this case, I think this could be a good buying opportunity in spot wallet for Cardano. Kasi of course, this is in the daily time frame, then that could be a possible good investment opportunity. Pero let's say you want to futures this, if you want to trade this in leverage trading, that could be possible. However, ang problem mo nga lang dyan is ano ba yung magiging best entry point mo dyan. So in that case, what you have to do is you have to dive in with a smaller time frame such as the hourly, and you have to monitor kay hourly kung is it now the best time to enter. Kasi let's say you are trading this within the hourly time frame, pero yung inyong analysis is just following for the daily time frame, then medyo magulo yan. Kasi of course, possible na masunugan ka if let's see nagkaroon pa siya ng mas malaking pullback for the Cardano price action during the smaller time frames, those intra-market cycle volatility, then possible na masunugan ka. Then in that case, if you are trading for the early time frame, then of course, you have to do an early time frame analysis. So in kanina na pinakita ko is for the daily time frame. So if you want to trade for the early, then you have to do an in-depth analysis first within the early time frame before entering into any trade. Now, this bullish divergence kay Cardano is still speculative kasi right now, we are still not yet seeing a bullish movement. And I think, personally, we could see a bullish price action as long as Bitcoin is able to flip bullish. So right now, this is what I'm monitoring with Cardano. So ang dapat mangyari, Bitcoin should remain bullish and healthy. At the same time, the dominance should be declining rather than increasing. Kasi of course, a declining dominance would indicate na altcoins are performing better. So right now, the dominance is declining. But if let's say we break this, itong support ng Bitcoin dominance, then we might see an altcoin season. Then possible na magkaroon tayo ng window area na pwedeng mahatak yung Cardano to the upside. But right now, it's still too early to tell and we still don't have a confirmation. But right now, we have a massive opportunity waiting out for the Cardano price action. Pero guys, let's say you want to trade Cardano with one of the lowest fees possible. You want to hold it in spot. You want to trade Cardano with the bigger time frames or you want to trade it with the smaller time frames. One of the best platform to trade Cardano is actually in Bybit kasi dito kay Bybit, mas muri ating trading fees as compared to Binance kasi diba nakita nyo kay Binance minsan or madalas na nga ang OA na nga na kanilang fees. Well, in fact, dito kay Bybit, meron na tayong option na pwede kayo mas trade ng mas murang fees and all you have to do is just go to bybit.com and then you could sign up with my sign up link na you can find in the description down below if you want to claim bonus dito. Then once sa Bybit ka na, all you have to do is just go to derivatives and then search for Cardano. So in this case, let's just type in ADA USDT. And then just select USDT perpetual for Cardano. If you want to trade Cardano, so all you have to do is just to click ADA USDT and then lalabas na dito si Cardano. So once na lumabas na siya dyan, you can actually now start trading Cardano if let's say you want to enter into a long position. So let's say gusto ko mag-open ng long position kay Cardano. And then let's just select market. And then let's say gusto ko mag-long position with 50% of my asset. So as you can see, if I'm going to open a long position, I'm going to leverage trade $40 of my current asset. And then let's say we want to do a 3x leverage, then we can actually set that. So let's say 3x leverage. And then let's use isolated. And then 3x leverage. So depende siya kung anong preference nyo. But if you want to learn yung ating in-depth tutorial on how to trade with leverage trading, with Bybit, you can actually check out the video in the description down below or itong card sa taas to see how can you trade with leverage trading and then yung ating in-depth futures tutorial. So once na ready ka na mag-open, let's say na-plot mo na yung $50 and then ready ka na mag-open long, just click open long and then you can actually see ito yung magiging resibo nyo. And then once na okay ka na dyan, just click confirm. And then as you can see, naka-open na inyong long position with the Cardano price action. So ngayon naka-open na yung long position, and then let's say you want to close this long position, you can now actually click limit. Ang limit naman, if let's say gusto mo siya i-close within a specific target area, you can actually set limit close. So let's say if umabot si Cardano ng 1.5, then magka-close na inyong position. Let's say 100% ng inyong Cardano price action yung inyong i-close. Then of course, pwede mo i-set ng 100, or let's say partial profit lang. Let's say gusto mo mag-take profit partially lang ng konti, then you can actually select ibang percentage, or you can actually select dito sa ating quantity kay Cardano. Now, if you want to close your Cardano trade, what you can actually do is just click market, and then pag naklik nyo na yung market, pwede nyo actually i-close kung ilang percent ng inyong asset yung gusto mo i-close. So let's see, gusto mo mag-take profit partially lang, just click 50%. Pero if you want to click your whole Cardano position, just click 100% and then just click confirm. So ganun kadali lang mag-futures and leverage trading dito kay Bybit. So in muna update natin for today, if you find this video useful and informative, please give this video a like. And if you want to see more contents like this, please subscribe for more. I'll see you in the next video, and bye-bye for now.